So you've started managing your projects using Agile Scrum. You're running your daily meetings, but are you running them correctly? I'm Daniel Hendy, and I'm going to give you three strategies on how to best run your stand-up meetings. Let's finally talk tech in plain English. I'm here to tell you how to take control of your company's technology. The three strategies are extremely simple. Standardize, ritualize, and then optimize. Before we continue, make sure you like and subscribe to stay updated on our latest content. So what's the hardest thing about working out? It's making it to the gym. Same thing with this process. If you aren't disciplined to have a daily stand-up every day at the same time, make sure everybody attends and everybody's paying attention, this isn't going to work. You need to make sure that that is standardized. Everybody's there on time every time. Make sure you keep it short. If it's more than 15, 20 minutes, you're probably getting sidetracked with off topics, going into too much detail per task. You want to make sure you keep it short. It's a stand-up meeting. You shouldn't have it long enough to where you want to sit down. It needs to be quick. Don't waste anybody's time. If you're getting sidetracked with other topics, delving in too deep per task, just take it offline. After the meeting, take you and that other person or the two people communicating about this topic and make sure they talk about that offline so that they don't have to waste everybody else's time. So during the stand-up meeting, again, you're running an Agile Scrum process. Your stand-up meeting is, what did you do yesterday? What are you going to do today? What are you blocked on and need help with? You want to make sure everybody worked a sufficient day yesterday. Otherwise, they need to explain how they're going to make it up. You need to make sure that they're going to work a efficient day today so that they don't accrue a new debt. And you want to make sure that they're unblocked. So if there's anything blocking them from moving forward or if they need assistance with, you get that to them as the project manager as soon as possible so we don't waste any cycles. Strategy number two, make sure you ritualize. Once the standard is in place and you go for a few weeks and a few months making sure that every day, 9 a.m., you're hitting that meeting and you're making sure everybody attends every time, it becomes a ritual. You don't think about it anymore. People stop showing up late. They show up on time. You make sure that everybody is used to showing up to the point where it's ritualistic so that even if you can't make it because you're sick that day, that you have a substitute that's going to play Scrum Master, the person who's asking everybody what they did, what they're going to do, and if they're blocked. And you make sure it continues even if you're not there. They're not doing this for you. It's ritualized to the point where this is part of me starting my day. And we all get together and it's a round table. It's not resource PM, resource PM, resource PM. It's us talking to each other so everybody else knows what we're doing. So even if the project manager isn't there, the rest of the resources between QA, developers, designers, and whomever else can communicate with each other and make sure everybody's on the same page of what they're doing and hold each other accountable. You need to make sure it's ritualized in your business. Only after you've established a standard and then ritualized it do you worry about strategy number three, optimizing. Now, once you have everything in place, you want to make sure that you get the most out of every meeting, the most out of every cycle. So using the workout example, if you want to start working out, the first thing you do is make sure you show up to the gym every day. Make sure you show up to the gym every day. It's difficult in the beginning, and you have to put an alarm in the beginning. But once it becomes ritualized, you don't even need that alarm. You're used to waking up at that time and making it to the gym. You're on autopilot. You're not even thinking about going to the gym. Your brain is somewhere else while your body's making it to the gym. That's when it's ritualized. Once you're there, you're already seeing results. You're immediately seeing results just by showing up and then keeping it consistent for a long time where it's ritualized, you're seeing results. Now you worry about optimizing. Now we worry about, are you bench pressing as much as you can? Are you doing the heaviest squat that you can, as many reps as you can, and so on. So the idea here is once your team is used to having a project management methodology, having daily stand-ups, making sure that these stand-ups aren't optional and they show up every single time, and being accountable for one another, you can then push them from a 60% focus factor to a 65 and 70%. You can then mandate certain QA cycles not to repeat over twice, meaning a developer only has one shot to make sure that it's tested, found one bug, fixed, and that's it. You can make sure that you can fine tune all your resources so they become superstars and not just B players. The other thing I do is towards the end of a sprint, So the first half I deal with, what are you doing? What are you going to do? Are you blocked on anything? The second half, I actually go through every single one of our epics and make sure this is 90% complete. Why is it not done yet? And you make sure you optimize that second half of the sprint to make sure every epic is done on time and that you don't have a bunch of loose ends at the end. So make sure that with your team, you optimize after a few sprints. And on every sprint, you make sure the latter half of your sprint, you optimize per epic to make sure everything is being tied up and you don't have any loose ends. Implement those three strategies and I guarantee you, you're going to get more out of your stand-up meetings. I hope you enjoyed that video. If there's a topic you'd like me to talk about, feel free to contact me on any one of these links below. If you'd like me to help on one of your projects, feel free to contact me as well.